I'm going to show you today how to connect to a wireless network using your Eee PC. The first thing you need to do is to look in the bottom right hand corner of the screen and check that this icon is here showing a radio signal with a spanner in front of it. When you're connected, there'll be a logo just on the right hand side of that, exactly the same but without the spanner. If that isn't there, check on the computer. In the bottom right hand corner of the actual computer itself, there's a set of four little lights. The one on the far right needs to be blue, otherwise the wireless is switched off. If that is the case, then press the function and F2 keys at the same time, and after about 1 or 2 seconds that light should be on. Once you've done that, then you know that you're ready to go, and this picture of the radio of the spanner should appear. Once that's done, if you go to the Internet tab on the Eee PC and go to Network, if you open that up, you'll see a list of the different connections that are already set up. This local area connection is the wired one on the side of the computer that lets you plug in with a cable, and then these two under here are ones that I've already set up, one at my parents' house and one at work. I'm at home right now, so we'll set one up here. If I click Create, a list will appear, showing me the different types of connection I can have. There's quite a few on here, but the one I want is a local area network wireless. Okay, not wireless point-to-point over Ethernet, but the local area network wireless. If I do next from there, that's the card inside the computer, so I'll just click next, and that's fine. After here, I'll get to a section that asks me for the network name. If you're using a hidden network, then you need to type that in, but for most cases you can just click Browse and you'll see a list. I've renamed mine Rich and Emma so I know it's mine, and so I don't have to introduce myself to our neighbours. But other people haven't, so you can see my neighbours have a BT Home Hub and my other neighbours have a Skybox. If you're not sure which one is yours, I'd just go for one with the highest signal and try it out. If it doesn't work, you can always try the others. The people can't tell that you're trying to connect, so don't worry about just trying it, even if you're not entirely sure. So, once you've chosen yours, just click Choose at the bottom, and it will automatically fill it in. The other two boxes are fine, so we'll click Next. That's also fine, so we'll go Next. Okay, here you get choices to enable encryption. Most home networks need encryption, but a lot of schools and offices do it slightly differently. But I'm at home right now, so I enable encryption. There's two choices on the E, WEP and WPA. WPA is a better way of doing it, for lots of reasons, but most routers ship with WEP, so I'll show you how to use that. It's no different, really, but WPA is a much better way of doing it. So anyway, as I say, I'm using WEP, so I need to type in the key here. I know the key because I've checked it on the box that the router came with, so I'll type that in here. And you can see underneath it's identified what sort of key that is. That doesn't really mean much to me, but it shows that it's picked that up as being something that makes sense to the computer. Once you've done this on web, you now need to choose that the key index is 1, okay, instead of just being blank. It's important that you do that, otherwise it won't work. I missed it the first time. Once you've done that, just click Next at the bottom and give it a name that will help you remember it. I'm going to choose Home because I'm at home. You then click Next. It will give you just a summary of the information you filled in. It doesn't really matter, but I want to connect automatically to System Starter and I want to start it right now. If you tick this box, it doesn't matter if you're not always going to be there, it just means when you get in range it will connect. So I would always tick both of these. Okay, then choose Finish and you'll see that the connection is disconnected. And now it's starting. I didn't do anything, but it's just starting itself up. If you wait for a few seconds, you should see, after a while, underneath here, I've now got that other picture. Look, I have the same rig, but without the spanner in front of it. And I can see up here, it now says Enabled. I can click OK, and if I go to Web, that will load a web browser, and I'll be able to check that everything's working. Okay, so here we go. Here's the internet and it's all working fine. So, that's the way that it needs to be set up. If you ever find that you turn it on and it doesn't connect automatically, just go back to Network here, And once it's loaded, just choose one you want, so home, and choose connection. And if I wasn't connected already, I'd be able to tell it now I definitely want to connect. Sometimes you need to do that if you don't have the computer start up in a certain area. For instance, when I go to work, I always have to manually tell it I want to connect. Right, that should be enough information for you, so good luck.